Dear child of God, the Lord have held his peace long enough, and it is time that he would not hold it anymore. The wickedness of the wicked had increased so much that now David would have to pray in Psalms 109 verse 1 to God, saying to him, "Hold not thy peace, O God of my praise, hold not thy peace." He says, "For the mouth of the wicked and the mouth of the deceitful are opened against me." He knew because of the mercies of God, because of the compassion of God, God had been merciful. He had been merciful to the enemies, and so he wouldn't strike them. But he got to a point in his life that he would tell God, "Enough is enough. Please do not hold your peace anymore. It is time for you to stretch your hands of vengeance. It is time for you to respond on my behalf." And the Lord did respond. The Lord responded so massively that the enemies felt it. Dear child of God, maybe it is time for the Lord to release his wrath. It is time for God not to hold his peace anymore. He said, "For the mouth of the wicked and the mouth of the deceitful are opened against me. They have spoken against me with a lying tongue." With a lying tongue, they have spoken against me. They have spoken things that I did not do, just to destroy my name, just to see that everything is not working again for me. Dear child of God, maybe you are in that situation right now, that they have heaped lies upon lies upon lies upon your head. They have been doing everything to see that your name is taken off. Maybe you need to tell God, "Please do not hold your peace again. Please, it is time for you to respond." He says, "They compassed me about also with words of hatred." They are speaking words of hatred to you every day. They are making you know how much they hate you. He said, "And fought against me without a cause." Dear child of God, you are looking for the reason why they hate you, and you still cannot find it. You are looking for the reason. You are diligently searching for the reasons why they are doing these things they are doing, and you still are not able to find the answer. And then it will resolve to saying, "Lord, please do not hold your peace anymore. You have been patient enough. It is time that you act on my behalf." And dear child of God, the Lord indeed acted. And the Lord made sure that the place of the enemy, everything that concerns the enemy, was taken from him. It is time for the Lord to act on your behalf. It is time for the Lord to turn everything around. Indeed, you have loved them the very best that you could. He said, "For my love, they are my adversaries." He was showing them love, and they turned the love he had towards them to hatred. There are some people you have loved. You have done everything for them. You are doing everything for them still, even in this present time, but they are fighting you. You are doing everything to see that all goes well with them. But dear child of God, they are still haunting you. They are still doing everything to be against you. He said he loved them and they turned it to hatred. And what he would do was to go to God in prayer. He said he gave himself to prayer. Psalms 109 verse 4. He says, "For my love, they are my adversaries, but I give myself unto prayer." Dear child of God, he gave himself unto prayer. And the prayer he made to God was, "God, do not hold your peace anymore. You have been patient enough. Please do not be patient again." And God began to reward them. God began to respond on his behalf. He said, "And they have rewarded me evil for good." Yes, for all the good you have shown to them, they have paid you evil. Dear child of God, you have become weary and tired. You have become so weak even for doing good. You do not want to do good anymore. Even for those who genuinely deserve it, you just don't want to do good anymore because of the reactions of the evil ones, of the wicked one. The Lord is telling you, yes, he's going to respond, and he will not hold his peace anymore. We know the God that we serve is patient. We know the God that we serve has long suffering with him. He knows how to take people. The Lord that we serve knows what it means to wait and be patient, to give people that gap, to give them that time. But it comes to a point in time in your life where you will tell God, enough is enough. These things cannot continue anymore. These yokes have to be broken. These burdens have to be taken off my neck. I need to enjoy my own life. It is time for me to live my life. It is time for me to make progress. They have stood in front of me long enough. I have loved them the very best I can, but they do not want to change. They seem to be evil more and more. The more I show them love, the more they respond with evil, the more they respond with wickedness, the more they respond in a way that is clear that they wanted me destroyed. And so you are telling God, please do not hold your peace anymore. The focus is him praying to God, saying, hold not thy peace, O God of my praise, because of all the cruelties, because of the words they have said, because of their lies, because of their falsehood, because of the false allegations. And the Lord is telling you, he will not hold his peace anymore. He would respond and he would set out against the wicked. He said, set thou a wicked man over him, dear child of God. Even the wicked ones that have been against you, it comes to a point that the Lord set a wicked man over him. That is, the Lord is delivering one who is stronger than him, stronger than her to them. Dear child of God, they have been fighting you. There are people that will come. They may not even know you, but they will come to fight on your behalf. They may not even associate with you. Those people may not even like you. But just because they have proven to be your enemies, God will create enemies greater than them and will take them off your path. Never will they disturb you anymore. And from that moment on, you'll begin to enjoy your peace. You'll begin to enjoy the rest that God have had in store for you. He said, set thou a wicked man over him and let Satan stand at his right hand. It comes to a point that the person they have been working for, the evil one, Satan, who they have been working for, would also turn against them. Dear child of God, let God do it the way he knows how to do it. Let God handle that situation for you. He knows how to turn the evil upon the head of the wicked. He knows how to return the wickedness of the wicked back to their head. He said, when he shall be judged, let him be condemned, and let his prayer become sin. Dear child of God, except they truly ask for mercy, except they truly ask for forgiveness, except they are coming to God to turn their ways, except they have thought over everything they have been doing and want to turn a new leaf, if not for that, except they come to God asking him to really forgive them. But if they refuse to change, dear child of God, this is what will happen. This is the word of God. David had real enemies. He had people who did not want him to progress. Like, he prayed and said to God, please turn the wisdom of Ahithophel, turn all of his counsels into foolishness. And God did. God responded. This was the same person that ate with him. This was the same person that grew with him. This was the same person that they fellowshiped together. But at a point in time, he only knew that what God would do for him was to turn everything that Ahithophel was doing against him back to his own head. And that meant the very end of Ahithophel. God would do for you what he needs to do for you. Just for you to have your peace. Just for you to have your rest. He would not hold his peace anymore, but he would respond to the enemies. He would respond on your behalf, and he will stop everything that has been done against you. Trust God to bring an end to this situation, and you would enjoy your life. You would enjoy what it means to be satisfied, and you will know peace again in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will stand for you and will turn everything around. Because of this, David will go to pray, and God heard his prayer. Because of his love that he had turned to hatred, he will go to God and God heard him. It's time that you go to God and tell God what you need to tell him. But if you are willing to repent, if you see the signs of changes in them, then tell God to have mercy and lift up the burdens upon their head and take away wickedness from their heart as well. And the Lord will take away wickedness from their heart, and everyone will be happy. May the Lord help you, and may the plans of the enemies not come to pass against your life. May all that they have been plotting not come to pass. May God never give you to the wish of the enemies, in the mighty name of Jesus. It is well with you, and you will know what it means to be preserved. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. It is well with you. God bless you, and shalom.